Hello and welcome back to another Vectortwist tutorial. This week's tutorial is all about the almighty isometric grid. As always at Vectortwist, we try to find the easiest and fastest way to do things. And I think I found an even easier way to create an isometric grid, and I will share it with you. We'll use a single line in the appearance panel to make a reusable graphic style that you can turn into a grid in any document. Yes, you heard correct. Out of one single line created in Adobe Illustrator. But before we start, make sure to subscribe to the channel so you'll never miss a tutorial. Open up a new document in Adobe Illustrator. The size doesn't really matter. Then grab the pen tool and make sure you turn off the fill and set the stroke to black. Change your stroke width from 1 point to 0.25. Then zoom out and create a vertical line. The size is approximately the size of your document. Make sure to hold and press the Shift key when you create the line so it will be straight vertically down. Keep the line selected and then we need to increase it. So simply double click the scale tool and in the pop-up increase it by 300%. Then click OK. I'm going to zoom out so we can see all of the line. We increased it by 300% to make sure that our grid that we're going to create will fit the artboard. After that, open up the appearance panel. I'm going to drag it out so you can see better what we're going to do with this line. On the bottom where you see the FX for add new effect, click it and then find distort and transform and choose transform. In the pop-up window, click the preview button and for copies, set a value of 1. Then when you go to the move for horizontal, put 36 points. 36 points or pixels equals half of an inch. As you can see in the background, we created one copy 36 points away from the first one. Now increase the copies to 100, and then you can see that we've created 100 copies and each separated by 36 pixels. This is the first step for our isometric grid, so simply press OK. We'll continue working with the appearance panel and we're going to add another new effect. So keep the line selected. We have one effect created, duplication 100 lines separated by 36 pixels, and now we're going to add another effect. So click the FX button again, go back to Distort and Transform, and choose Transform. We'll get the pop-up window again, and now we're going to add another effect. Again, click the Preview button, set the copies for 1 so we see what we're going to do, and then in the Rotate panel, we're going to change the angle. Set it to 60 degrees. Then click OK. As you can see on the artboard, we have two effects now. One vertical line duplicated and then the same, simply rotated by 60 degrees. I'm going to zoom in so we can see it a little bit better. I still have the line selected, so keep continuing with the line selected and then continue with the appearance panel to add another effect. So go back to the Add New Effect button. Find Distort and Transform again and choose Transform. There in the pop-up, same steps, click the preview, set the copies to 1. And we're going back to the Rotate, and for the angle this time, we're going to set minus 120 degrees. Then click OK. Now if I zoom out and move the line over a little bit, you can see that we've created an isometric grid on our artboard. And all we have done is use one single vertical line and added 3 effects via the appearance panel. In order to keep your line with the effect permanently in Adobe Illustrator, we need to turn it into a graphic style and save it properly. So I'm going to zoom out. As you can see, I still have my line selected with the 3 effects applied. And now we're going to save it as a graphic style. We need to open the graphic style panel. So go to Window and choose Graphic Styles. Deselect anything on your artboard and then delete all of the styles you do not want to have in the panel. So I'm going to select everything and delete it. I simply have 1 style left by default. Then I'm going back onto the artboard, select the line with your effects, and then click the New Graphic Style button. This will add the new graphic style to your panel. After that, simply double-click it and give it a name that makes sense to you. So in this case, I'm going to call it IsoGrid. Then click OK. The next step is to save the graphic style within Adobe Illustrator. So no matter what new document you open, you can always open it up and then create your new isometric grid on your new document. In the graphic style panel, click the flyout panel, and all the way on the bottom, choose Save Graphic Style Library. You will already be brought to the graphic styles within Adobe Illustrator. So again, give it a name that makes sense to you, and then click Save. Now if you go back to the graphic styles panel and click the flyout, and scroll all the way to Open Graphic Style Library, under User Defined, you will find now where you've saved your isometric graphic style. To use the graphic styles to create an isometric grid is really neat, since you can easily change the grid size. So let me show you how you can do this. So select the line again. In the Appearance panel, you still see your three effects that you've added. And then with the first effect, just double-click it. And in the pop-up, you can change the horizontal values. For example, we've used 36 pixels, which is half an inch, but you can either decrease it or increase it, whatever size you would like your grid to be. So if I'm going to set a value of 18 points, for example, I click the preview, on the artboard you can see that the grid size is smaller. Or I could even make it bigger, and instead of 36, I can put 72, and then click the preview and then see that my grid increased as well. Then all you have to do is click OK, and that's it. Once you increase your grid, of course you have to zoom out and move it better into place. But this way you have control over the grid size. Since the graphic style has the effects added via the appearance panel, they're still live effects, they have not been expanded. The next step is to show you how to turn it finally into a grid and make guides out of them. So select your line with the styles applied, then go to Object and click Expand Appearance. As you can see, everything has been expanded now. Keep everything selected, and all you need to do is go under View, Find Guides, and then choose Make Guides. Now when you zoom in, you can see that your lines have been turned into guides, and with the shortcut Command or Control and semicolon, you can turn them off or on. And at the same time, working with the smart guides, you can create now isometric designs. And all we have done is use one single vertical line. And that's it. So let me just clear the guides on the artboard. So I simply go to View, Guides, and select Clear Guides. I'm going to zoom out and just show you again what we've just done. Let's close everything here, go back to Window, choose Graphic Styles, and then click the Flyout menu. Go to Open Graphic Style Library, and either under User Defined or under the other drop-downs, choose the grid that you've just turned into a graphic style. So I'm going to select it, it's going to open it, and here you have your isometric grid as a graphic style. Then simply select again a stroke for the color and none for the fill, and create a vertical line on your artboard. So with the pen tool, create a straight vertical line. Hold and press the Shift key to do so. Keep the line selected, and then simply click on your graphic style. Then just move it into place. As you can see, you have your isometric grid with the three effects. Again, these are live effects, you can change them anytime. All you have to do is open up the Appearance panel. So go to Window, Appearance, and in the Appearance panel, you can double-click any of the effects you've added. If you're happy with the size of your isometric grid, keep it selected, go to Object, Expand Appearance, move it into place for your artboard, and then simply go to View, Guides, and choose Make Guides. And now you are ready to create your isometric art. And that's it. So if you like this video and appreciate what we do here at Vectortwist, let us know by hitting the like button, leave a comment, share it with your friend. It really makes a difference. It helps us reach more people that want to learn Illustrator just like you. And before you go, hit the subscribe button and also click the notification bell so you'll be notified when the next Vectortwist tutorial is live. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.